Hi, my name is Abel, and I'm a cloud developer advocate specializing in DevOps. Visual Studio Team Services is the ultimate DevOps solution into Azure. And now, with the general availability of Azure DevOps Project, we make it incredibly simple to take an existing ASP.NET 4 app, build out a complete CI/CD pipeline for it, and then deploy that app into infrastructure up in Azure. And you can do all of this with just a couple of clicks. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to create a resource from the Azure portal. And the resource that we want to create is an Azure DevOps project. Now, it's going to ask us, what language do we want to use? In our case, we already have an existing ASP.NET 4 application. So we can just say, let's bring our own code. We'll click on Next. And now it's going to ask us, where is your code sitting? For this example, my code is sitting in GitHub, so I'm just going to go ahead and pull that down. I've already connected my Azure account to my GitHub account, so in a little bit here, we'll be able to see all of my GitHub repos. So here they are. You can see here's my repository. I'm going to pull down the master branch. I'll go ahead and select on Next. And now it's going to ask me, your code, what type of code is it? It turns out my code, ASP.NET 4, but we have all sorts of choices. It could be a .NET Core app, it can be a Node.js app, it can be a PHP, Python, Ruby, or Go. For this example, it's an ASP.NET application. We'll click on Next, and we'll deploy this into Azure Web Apps. We'll click Next again. It's going to ask us, what instance of Visual Studio Team Services should we use? Should we create a brand new one or use an existing one? For this example, we'll go ahead and use my demo account. So let me find my demo account. We'll give this project a name. And from here, we need to choose the location that we're going to deploy to. Since I live on the West Coast, let's go ahead and choose the West Coast. We click on Done. And bam, that's all we need to do. Now we can kick back, Azure's gonna do its thing, and build for me a full CI/CD pipeline that's gonna be connected to my GitHub repo. And any changes made to the GitHub repo, it will send it through a CI/CD pipeline that will build my application and then deploy my app all the way out into Azure. And when it's done building me my DevOps project, I get a portal that looks something like this, where on the left-hand side, I see all the links to my CI/CD pipeline, and on the right-hand side, I see all the resources that the DevOps project created for me in Azure. Now, these links are deep links that take me into whatever that I'm clicking on. So if I click on the code, it's going to take me into GitHub, where I stored my code. Now, I can come down here and click on the build, and it's going to take me to the build definition that's in VSTS. Now let's go ahead and edit this so you can see what it's doing. But what we're doing here is we're going to create for you a pipeline that makes sense for the technology that you picked. So you can see that the source is connected to our GitHub account, and what we're doing, we're going to restore our packages from NuGet, we're going to build our solution, we're going to run all the tests, and then we're going to publish everything back up to VSTS. Now, for most cases, this is all you need to do. But if you did need to customize this, it's easy to customize a build in VSTS. It's just a task runner. All you need to do is add or remove tasks. And out of the box, there are hundreds of tasks that you can pick from. If what you want to do doesn't exist out of the box, go ahead and jump in the marketplace. Because in the marketplace, our partners have created over 500 build and release tasks that you can just start using. Now, if what you want to do doesn't exist in the marketplace and it doesn't exist out of the box, not a big deal because you can create your own custom tasks. A custom task, nothing more than PowerShell or Node.js. So literally, you can get this build and release system in VSTS to do whatever you need it to do. We do the same thing in our release pipeline as well. So if we jump into the release pipeline, we create for you a release pipeline that makes sense for the technology that you picked. In our case here, we're going to go ahead and deploy into Azure App Service, so we use one Azure App Service tasks. Once again, easy enough to come in here and customize this, maybe build out lots of different environments, whatever you need to do, simple enough to do. Now, jumping back into the Azure portal, we'll be able to see our application endpoint, and if we click on it, it'll take us directly into our app that's already been deployed up in Azure. Bam, there you go. You get all of this goodness with the Azure DevOps Projects with just a couple of clicks. Azure DevOps Projects makes creating your end-to-end DevOps pipelines into Azure incredibly simple. With a couple of clicks, everything just starts working. And yet, you still have full control over your CI/CD pipelines to customize it and configure it to do whatever you need. For more information about Azure DevOps Projects, go to docs.microsoft.com. Thank you.